white man first came here from over the sea. He looked and he said, this is God's own country. He was mighty well pleased with his land that he'd found. And he said, I will make here my own piece of ground. Now the land was inhabited, so I've heard say, by little men who painted on the rock face by day. They stuck to their land, so we shot them all down and left them to rot on their own piece of ground. Well, many is the battle that I still had to fight. Many was the family that died in the night, 'cause many were the black men that lived all around, and all of them wanting their own piece of ground. So northwards he trekked and northwards he rode, over felt and tough countryside onwards he strode. In the Free State and the Transvaal his oxen outspanned, and he planted the seed in his own piece of land. Then one fine day in 1883, gold was discovered in good quantity. The country was rich, much richer than planned, and each digger wanted his own piece of land. Now the diggers were few, and the gold was so deep, that the black man was called 'cause his labor was cheap. With drill and with shovel he toiled underground, fourpence a day for 10 tons of ground. Now this land is so rich, and it seems strange to me, that the black man whose labor has helped it to be cannot enjoy the fruits that abound. Is uprooted and kicked from his own piece of ground. Well, some people say, now don't you worry, we've kept you a nice piece of reserve territory. But how can a life for so many be found on a miserable 13% of the ground? Yes, some people say, now don't you worry, you can always find jobs in the white man's city. But don't stay too long, don't stay too deep, or you're bound to disturb the white man in his sleep. Don't sleep long, don't sleep too deep, or your life and your possessions, how long will you keep? For I've heard a rumor running around that the black man's demanding his own piece of ground.